Blessed morning, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to Carmelite Monastery. Today is the second Sunday of Easter. In today's Gospel, Christ calls blessed those who believe without seeing. Jesus had shown himself to the apostles. He is alive and reigns in glory. The response of Thomas is for every believer. We confess Jesus as our Lord and God, though we have not seen him with our own eyes. Seeing him with the eyes of faith, we give testimony to this faith by our living hope and active service to our brothers and sisters. Today is also Divine Mercy Sunday. This celebration is a perennial call to every Christian to face with confidence in divine benevolence the difficulties and trials that humankind will experience in the years to come. Let us now rise and welcome our Lord Jesus Christ in the person of his minister, Reverend Father Francis Montero.
Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends, as we gather today, on the Sunday after the Resurrection, also called the Divine Mercy Sunday, we pause for a few moments of silence and, number one, thank the Lord for his grace and his mercy in our lives. Thank the Lord for His providence and His, according to the introduction, His benevolence. Ang kaluoy sang Diyos, kagrasya sang Diyos. And then pause for a few moments of silence and bring before the Lord at this altar, what blessing would you like the Lord to give you today, especially in this beautiful Sunday morning? We also greet and invite in our celebration today those who are on streaming, on podcast, through Facebook and YouTube, that despite the distance, despite the isolation, despite the fear, they will know that God is near. And as we come together to celebrate this wonderful mystery of our faith, we call to mind our sins and humbly ask the Lord for pardon and for strength. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
in the highest. Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal Feast kindled the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Through the apostles, the risen Jesus works with signs and wonders, which strengthen the community of believers. The believers, in turn, earn the esteem of the people. The first reading.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Many signs and wonders were done among the people at the hands of the apostles. They were all together in Solomon's portico. None of the others dared to join them, but the people esteemed them. Yet more than ever, believers in the Lord, great numbers of men and women were added to them. Thus they even carried the sick into the streets and laid them on cots and mats, so that when Peter came by, at least his shadow might fall on one or another of them. A large number of people from the towns of the vicinity of the Jerusalem also gathered, bringing the sick and those disturbed by unclean spirits, and they were all cured. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This is the day.
exiled for the faith, John describes his vision of the risen Christ, master of life and death. Christ is with us, especially in times of trials and difficulties. The second reading.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, your brother, who share with you the distress, the kingdom, and the endurance we have in Jesus, found myself on the island called Patmos, because I proclaimed God's word and gave testimony to Jesus. I was caught up in the spirit of Lord's day and heard me behind a voice as loud as a trumpet, which said, write on a scroll what you see. Then I turned to see whose voice it was that spoke to me, and when I turned, I saw seven gold lampstands, and in the midst of the lampstands, one like a son of man, wearing an ankle-length lent robe with a gold sash around his chest. When I caught sight of him, I fell down at his feet as though dead. He touched me with his right hand and said, do not be afraid. I am the first and the last, the one who lives. Once I was dead, but now I am alive forever and ever. I hold the keys to death and the nether world. Write down, therefore, what you have seen and what is happening and what will happen afterwards. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all rise.
You believe in me, Thomas, because you have seen me, says the Lord. Blessed are those who have not seen me, but still believe.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for the fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst, and he said to them, peace be with you. When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you. And when he said this, he breathed in them and said to them, receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained. Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, we have seen the Lord. But he said to them, unless I see the mark of the nails in his hand, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe. Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, peace be with you. Then he said to Thomas, put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe. Thomas answered and said to him, My Lord and my God. Jesus said to him, Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed. Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book. But these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through his disbelief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In 2020, the world was taken by surprise. I'm sure you're one of them that did not believe that we will shut our borders, that we will be distancing, you know, 1.5 meter apart, or perhaps that we will be wearing masks as a norm of our life. That even when we go in public, walking in the streets, we tend to cover our faces, a bit ashamed of who we are as a son and daughter of God. That's the impression that perhaps the world wants to impose on us because of this pandemic. 2.5 years later, we're still doing the same, with a bit more ease, with a bit more confidence, but still with fear. 2,000 years ago, when Jesus died, they were afraid. They were hiding. They were discouraged. Some of them even left Jerusalem and went home to Emmaus because they thought that the battle is lost, that the message, you know, that the message did not matter at all. They were downcast. They were afraid. They should rather be wearing masks during that day because of shame, because of fear. Remember when Peter said, I do not know him? When the women and some people asked him, You're one of them. When Jesus was on trial, he said, I do not know him. 3 times he denied Jesus. It was better for him to wear the mask so that he would not be recognized. You know, I'm sure that I know some of you here. At least you know me. The commentator announced my name. But the sad part is that we cannot even give ourselves and each other a warm embrace. But what we can do is that with the same words of Jesus and the powerful words when he said to them, And I say to you, and we say to each other, peace be with you. Can you do that, please? And look around. The message of peace is a powerful message, especially at the beginning of the Mass when Sister Rosa prayed for the intentions and invite us to pray for President Volodymyr Zelensky of Ukraine. I'm not sure if you heard that because there are too many names that were mentioned, but it caught my attention that the people of Bacolod here in Carmel is specifically praying for a person so far away that many of us haven't been there in Ukraine. I know we've heard about Ukraine and Crimea when Putin many years ago invaded Crimea, and now the country, he wasn't satisfied with a piece of cake, a slice of cake. He wanted the whole cake. You know what greed can bring to man's heart. So we pray. We pray for him because the message of peace is very real to the people here in Carmel Monastery. But it should also be real in the hearts of the men, women, and the children in Ukraine. And it should be real in the leadership in Russia because they should also have that heart of peace. Today, we celebrate the Feast of the Divine Mercy. And everything is grace, and everything is mercy. We cannot attribute anything for ourselves except that we have been graced by God and we have been mercifully treated. One of the apostles, not one of the 12, one that was admitted by Christ himself, invited to convert, a change of heart, a murderer, St. Paul. He was called Saul before that. When he had a conversion, when he fell on the road to Damascus, and God gave him the chance, he saw the light. And then when he became a Christian, he became the most stalwart, the most passionate missionary of their time that inspires even the people of today. The missionary heart and passion of St. Paul reverberates even in today's world. He said in his writings to the Thessalonians, I was once a murderer, but I was mercifully treated. Mercifully treated. Think, dear friends, think of the sin that you think that God will not forgive you. Think of the acts that you have done in the past or even today that seems to be unforgivable. And sometimes even in our hearts will condemn us. We condemn ourselves because of that sin or sins. St. Paul, one of my favorite writers, he said, even if our heart condemn us, God is greater than our hearts. And the mercy and the grace of God is given to us for free. He died on the cross so that we will be justified before God, so that we can ever and forever sing the Easter Alleluia. Heard that word? Alleluia? I cannot see your smiles, obviously. We all have masks. But I can see your eyes. They talk. Try to say Alleluia disgusted. Try to say Alleluia frowning. It won't go out. Hindi magwa sa ba naton. Hindi natin ma-pronounce ang Alleluia kung nagakusmod ka. Hambal bala, cheers, nga nagakukusmod. Hambal bala, payday. May sweldo. Payday. Gayuhom ka ginaya. Payday. I can see your smiles under your mask. Anong pizza, subong man? Wala pa sweldo. So, hindi pa ka mo magyuhom. Alleluia is a sacred word in the sacred text. A word that cannot be said without smiling. Isn't it wonderful? No, that word. And so we are an Easter people, and Alleluia is our song. We are in Easter. And today, we are guided by the Apostle Thomas, whom the world has labeled Doubting Thomas. Did he doubt the Lord that would appear to them? Did he ever doubt the Lord? I'm sure many of you would believe that he doubted the Lord. For me, I do not believe it. He doubted the veracity of the other disciples. Ano nga sa Tagalog yan? Uy, andito si Jesus? Anong sagot niya? Di nga. Di ba? Tood? Doya mo hat balaka mo? I think that's how he felt. Why would the Lord appear that he is not there? Of all the days after the resurrection, because he was there perhaps when the women told them. Remember at the dawn mass of Easter, Mary Magdalene, Mary wife of Cleopas, and another Mary went to the tomb and found the tomb was empty. And the angel said, he is not here. He is alive. Try to say the word alive, frowning. Impossible. He is alive. And then the women went to Peter and the disciples. You know what they did? they confirmed. Tuod bala, naglagan sila. They ran towards the tomb to make sure that the women were telling the truth. Because they were women. And why wasn't Peter condemned in Scripture? Why only Thomas? Palarihos man na sila? Palarihos man lang ta? Peter denied Jesus 3 times. They ran to the tomb because they did not believe Mary Magdalene, because a woman of ill repute. Diba? Do parang drop lagi star ho sa mga igpat-igpat, papati ka bala na? Amo na tanang judgment, the world judges people because of their past. They were no different than us. Bala? And at the crucifixion, diba that the song, "Where are they? Were you there when they crucified my Lord?" Din sila. Tatlo to ka babae ho gatindog sa cross. Kag isa ka lalaki nga bata. John. I'm not even sure if he was really, you know, meant to be there. Basi gin kapta ng iyakamot ni Maria, Drika. Langga, abla. Lipat ka. You know, John, actually, some scholars would say John was there because of Mary. Doesn't really matter. Because today, you and I make the decision to stay with Jesus. As Peter was forgiven by the Lord, because the Lord looked at him straight, and that look was a look of mercy. When Jesus reappeared to them again after a week, with closed doors, he said the message, "Peace be with you." And he called Thomas. Sino nasugig ni Jesus man? Ang muna bala may sala ka sa balay? Kag nabalaan sa parents mo, ang bimong imo manghod ng sugid. Dugay-dugay awayon mo na siya. Kaya nga snitch. Di bala? Family dynamics na. Sino na yan? Who told Jesus? But Thomas came and he got what he wished. I'd rather doubt and touch the wounds of Jesus than those who pretended not doubt and they were just looking. Don't you think Thomas got a reprimand? No. He got the best deal. He was able to touch the marks of the passion of Jesus. Now, if we're just looking at it in a movie point of view, gatanaw kita sini, and then when we look at we'd say, wow, how lucky Thomas is. While the world judged him as a doubter, Jesus gave him the chance to touch the passion. In our doubts, the Lord can come and invite us to touch his wounds. So sometimes, in our doubts, in our difficulties, in our pain, that is the time of encounter with Christ. Pope Francis, he describes the church as a field hospital, a place where people can come and get healing and treated. And in the field hospital, you do not ask the question, Catholic ka, Methodist ka, born again ka, Christian ka, Muslim ka, Hindu. You don't do that in the field hospital. If you've been nurses or doctors or medical professionals, whoever comes to your door or whoever is in on that bed, you will just lovingly serve that person. So in the church is a field hospital. People tell me that I'm a bit out of, some renegade sa rules. People who know me here in Bacolod, I was never a renegade of rules, liturgy, liturgy, liturgy. Gamudlat pa na mata ko ya, maghambal sa liturgy. But sometimes when you be in a place like Australia, that we really don't know who goes in our doors. Of course, we know our parishioners. But sometimes people come to those doors that you have no idea who they are. Are they passing through? Are they tourists? I tell you, wala to yung may matour sa ako niya nga banwa. Disyerto to ya, matour sila to. Wala to yung may makita. Except camel, wala to yung camela. Kangaroo, nga ma-aksidente ka na sa kangaroo. So, and then, at communion time, they will just cross their arms, indicating that just they need a blessing. Then you talk to them at the end of the Mass, Father, we're not Catholics, but we found a church, and we feel that the Lord is calling us to sit down and pray. Like on Holy Thursday, for the washing of the feet, when Jesus knelt down, he did not look sino ni Tilman kay Judas, kumusog ubini kay traidor ni siya. No, Jesus washed the feet of Judas because he loved him nevertheless. The message of Easter is that of mercy. Yes, we rejoice, we sing, we say the Alleluia. But also, we celebrate the mercy of God victorious. And today, Thomas can give us a beautiful inspiration that even in his doubt, he got the front seat. He was able to touch the wounds, the marks of the passion of his Lord. That's why he said, my Lord and my God. And that awe, that wonder, that excitement should be the same thing that you feel today in his heart as we break open his word and we break the bread. That as you approach today the sacrament of his divine mercy, let that be the exclamation of your heart, my Lord and my God. And then Jesus said to them, as the Father has sent me, so I send you. World Youth Day 1995. As the Father has sent me, so I send you. So when we finish this Mass here, you go out those gates. Usually I say you go out those doors. Kasi may mga tao sa sagwa. You go out those gates. Bring the peace, the love, the mercy, and the joy of the resurrection outside. Kung magkaon ka mo, mag-shopping ka mo, kung magpuli ka mo sa inyo nga balay, hindi anay ka mo mangaking sa inyo nga bata nga wala pa kasimba. May misa pa man sa hapon sa ibang simbahan. Don't get upset today. Treat today as a day of mercy, as grace. Because from that perspective, from that point of view, you'll able to see everybody as God sees St. Paul, that I was treated mercifully. That you would see everybody as Jesus see Thomas. Come, Thomas, see my wounds, touch it. And then, with that perspective, we can shout with confidence, my Lord and my God. My dear friends, as the word has been broken, as the word has been shared, and the Eucharist is being prepared, may the love of God and His mercy be with you all. Amen.
Please all rise.
Let us profess our Christian faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Father of endless mercy and boundless compassion, look upon us with love as we lift up to you our supplications. And we pray, merciful Father, hear us.
Merciful Father, hear us.
Reborn in baptismal waters, may the Church carry on the healing mission of Christ in the midst of a troubled world. We pray.
Merciful Father, hear us.
By the power of your word of life, break through the fears of the leaders of our nation, so that they may be empowered instruments of justice. We pray.
Merciful Father, hear us.
Through your freeing love, may those who are sick, depressed, anxious, and all who are in any form of bondage be led to the peace and healing presence of the risen Lord. We pray.
Merciful Father, hear us.
Enable those who are in despair because of their weaknesses and sinfulness to draw near to the front of mercy. Jesus Christ, your Son, we pray.
Merciful Father, hear us.
Trusting in the truth of your gospel, may our beloved dead, who hoped in your mercy, find home and contentment in the eternal life you have promised. We pray.
Merciful Father, hear us.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Merciful Father, hear us.
Gracious Father, hear us as we call on your mercy. Sustain us with your gifts of faith, hope, and love as we savor the Easter festivities with great joy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Please all rise.
Pray, dear friends, that my sacrifice, as well as yours, be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and of those you have brought to new birth, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain an ending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is a true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death. By rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they all acclaim. Holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts that are brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. Save us, Savior of the world. For by your
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Patricio, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by his divine teaching, we dare to pray. Deliver us, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with thee always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are you called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
For those who are joining our live stream celebration, let us now pray the spiritual communion prayer. O my Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you and I desire you to come into my heart. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you. O never leave me. May the burning and most sweet power of your love consume me, that I may die for you who died for love of me. Amen. Please all rise.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Prayer of the Synod. We stand before you, Holy Spirit, as we gather together in your name. With you alone to guide us, make yourself at home in our hearts. Teach us the way we must go and how we are to pursue it. We are weak and sinful. Do not let us promote disorder. Do not let ignorance lead us down the wrong path, nor partiality influence our actions. Let us find in you our unity, so that we may journey together to eternal life and not stray from the way of truth and what is right. All this we ask of you, who are at work in every place and time, in the communion of the Father and the Son, forever and ever. Amen.
Before I give the final blessing, I'd just like to thank the Carmelite community who have graciously allowed me to celebrate the Mass here with and for you. Thank you for your continuous prayer for our ministry wherever we are. Thank you for your motherly love for the priest. And I'm assigned in Australia, and thank God that after 3 years, we're able to travel. So I hope to travel in July again. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confirm on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessings.
Amen.
Amen. May he, who by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace and love of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.